Hey YouTubers and friends, I'm down here again at Pirates Cove. There's a whole bunch of us here, the Wandering Buffaloes, and Kayla Bennington from Kansas, John Miller, my partner Toledo Jess ended up showing up. I came down with Dano the Mano. But gotta pay attention to the steps or fall in. We did some setup and we did a little dowsing and penduluming. You can hear in the background and behind me now is David Bogan and his wife and Karrie and some other people. I believe Derek Simmons gonna be here and maybe Dennis Dayton. I don't know, but it's a good showing. We're over this way. Where we decided to work. I'm gonna head over there, say hi to them and David. I haven't seen him since Nashville, him and his wife. And say hi to them and then get to digging. So, put down my coffee. Don't want to spill my coffee. Well, be back in a bit.
Hey, YouTubers and friends. Well, I'm home and I'm out there. I don't know how. Sleuthing up and running, we're in horse though. We're in real hard to do all we can. Every day on a creeker bee, flashing your pan. Every day on a creeker bee, flashing your pan.
The bucket by Simo Gold Outfitters running there, and then we have the Bucketbilly Sluice with Prospector's Dream Mask in the sluice. And here we are today at Pirates Cove. As you already know, we have Kayla Bennington over here and Patrick Moore. How are you guys?
Good.
Excellent. Good to have you here from Kansas.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Caleb, Patrick, you're a local. Thank you for having us.
No problem.
And then we have Dano the Mano, as you know. Toledo Jess. Then we have John Miller over here. Say hi, John. And
hi. Then,
say hi, Jeff.
Hi, Jeff.
Yeah, he always does that. And then we have other people over there where, well, eventually I'll get over there. But I'm going to get to digging for a little bit and I'll see y'all later. Kayla going to town. Patrick said he met for the kill or something. What you doing?
Man, getting all the bubbles out of the vortex, man.
Oh, okay. And here we are running the bucket. So. Dan over there. Well, we're working this area, heading that way, and trying to back this way towards John, and running it through, as you know, the bucket onto the green mat. We have Dana over here with the Pentecost and John Miller with the speed. The Dana Mano machine right there. We have Taylor Bennington over here running his job. Running the dream mat also. Doing your first clean out?
Yeah, I got a hole. I just want to see if I'm on anything or not.
How does it look so far? Too soon into it, you know?
Yeah.
Oh. Alright, be back later. Patrick's running his tube with the Fox Trommel. I'm gonna leave my amigos for a minute and go over and talk to the wandering Biffalos and wandering Biffalos and
I think they're, it's the buffalo.
I know the buffalos. Scott Swiftwater Tony calls them the wandering Biffalo. I'm gonna go over there, say hi to Rich Cooley, his friend I never met.
Staying over here and doing, yeah, you know.
Oh, okay. He's staying here. I'll be right back. But I'm gonna mosey on. I'll see you in a minute. It's amazing how much trash we prospectors take out of the waterways of America. Beach balls, lead, mercury, glass, wire, barbed wire, and other heavies we take out of our waterways as we help reclaim the fish habitat throughout America with small-scale placer mining in general. I'm going up to Dano's car, heat up my coffee, take this out. Might as well pack it out so we could come back here again, but evidently we found out this is public notice or public access, so not much they can do. Okay, I'm back at Dano's truck. I'll be right back. Got my coffee refilled. Gonna head down into the river. It's stream, actually. This isn't a river, it's a stream. Southwest of Indiana. Yeah, nice little dammy thingy here. Coming up, we have Mr. Shad Biffle. His other half over there, Kathleen Biffle. Hello, Shad.
Hey, buddy.
Then we have Karrie running her stuff. Running the Marvin. Yeah, bull. Big Cooley over here.
Ted Marvin.
With the friend. And then we have Mr. David Bogan. Barbecue Bogan. And his wife over there, Meda. How you doing, Rich?
Pretty good. How are you, buddy?
Good, good. I'm out on the river.
You just missed it. We had a nice little... Little one, you can almost pick it up. I mean, it was a pretty good size, yeah.
There was a pretty good track over here somewhere.
There was
what? It goes across the creek like this. Jesse and I did pretty good.
Yeah,
and Caleb worked the other side.
They cleared that out yesterday, Derek and them, over there with that big opening with.
Yeah.
And they got some nice big pieces out of there, too.
Right,
we had a couple big rocks here we got out, and now we're going down to hit bedrock again.
Oh.
We're going to clean this area out. The dowsing rod's hit over in there again, so we're going to work away. He's going to work his way this way, and we're going to meet in the middle and got to clear all this off.
So, excellent. Excellent.
That's scary. Keep digging.
Yeah, buddy. Carrie's going down. Right on, I thought I'd stop being rude. We got our stuff down here and sat up and ran for a little bit, and I'm like, I gotta go over see Rich.
Jesse over there?
Yeah. I'm like, I have to go see Rich.
Yeah.
We're right by Caleb and Patrick and John Miller.
Uh-huh.
Have you got to use that cleanup sluice at all?
I did at home. I ran it at home.
How do you like it?
I like it. Worked out really good. I ran that material that I won from Dennis.
Right.
I bought it. The bottles at the motel, or I'd show you what I got all out of it.
Well, you're just happy with it, right?
Yes, I am.
That's
great.
All I care about, bud.
I'm not going to complain. I like it.
I won't mention any names, huh? Unlike some people... Yeah. Well, guys, I'll talk to you later.
Right,
when are you out of here?
We're leaving tomorrow morning.
Okay, so you'll be here all night, all day.
Yep, we'll be here all day to the end of the day. Then we got to haul all our gear out of here.
Right yeah. On.
Then we're going for supper tonight. We're having Mexican. Going to Eldorado, I believe, there.
What, everybody?
Yep.
Eldorado.
You guys are welcome.
Eldorado?
Eldorado, straight beside the Blueberry Hill Pancake Restaurant.
Where's that at?
Gun shop right beside there.
Is that in Moreauville or?
Yeah, Mooresville.
Mooresville?
Mooresville.
Mooresville?
Yep.
All right.
That's where we're having supper.
We'll visit later when we're all breaking. I gotta get back to digging.
I hear you.
I know
that gold,
you too. You talk to
me. In your pan.
That's right, my friend. And that's one of the reasons I always say, maybe one day too, I'll see you on the river. And it's the same way with Karrie right here. I actually saw Karrie at the Dayton show, and now I'm seeing her on the river. And this is why I say YouTubers and friends. And what do I always say, Karrie?
There'll always be a flash in your pan.
Yeah, and maybe one day too, I'll see you on the river. How you doing, girl? Right on, I see you have the double D attachment. Dennis Sector, I mean, talked you into buying one.
Hey, I found some gold in it yesterday, so.
Well, I support Dennis Dayton, so.
Yeah.
Talk to you later, Karrie. Now we have the world famous Kathleen Biffle, co-host of Prospectors Radio, over here doing some crevicing and about almost mossing almost, but not quite much moss. So how you doing?
I ripped some of this off, put it in there to rinse off.
So how? Oh yeah, take everything.
Tool and then sometimes.
Is that one of Sherba Shad's creation?
This one? No. We ended up losing that one at the Double T.
Oh, so that looks like a Joe product or a Martin product.
Yeah. And then I take this little...
Gutter cleaner.
Kind of scrape the bedrock because it's flat and then you put everything in there.
You're learning stuff.
In there.
Do you have any good colors this morning?
We're doing our first clean out right now.
Well, how about you? Have you been doing any sampling while you're doing?
Yeah, and then,
obviously,
doused.
You got colors.
Oh, yeah.
Doused.
But we doused first. Right. And, found some good reading right here.
I'll give you that pendulum.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, you got
it. I have two others.
Oh, wow.
Here, take it out of this one. Mine's in the...
Honey. We can catch up later.
Oh, yeah. We'll be here all day.
Yeah, we're here all day. And are you guys going out to dinner with us?
I don't know, but Richie brought something up about it, so I'm sure we will.
Okay. Cool.
And the better half of the Bogan Barbecue crew. How are you doing, Mrs.
Doing
Bogan?
Right. Learning how to crevice, and it's awesome. Myself a little pocket here, so we're hoping for the best.
Have you done any sample pans?
Not yet sample. Yesterday I did, and I got 5 flakes out of 1 scoop.
Excellent. Totally awesome. Awesome. Well, y'all, I'll see y'all later.
See ya.
May you have a flash in your pan. Woo! How is it looking?
Oh. A lot of nice black sands.
Well, we're not mining black sands, my friend.
Well, we got a good indicator.
Yeah, true.
A lot of heavies. So.
Well, that's always good. Did you know little flashes in your matting?
Yeah, saw a couple.
Excellent. So. Sweet. Well, I'm heading over there. Shovel again. And I'll talk to you later, Shad.
Good luck.
Thank you, sir. You too. Gonna go through there, but I guess not. I'm gonna get back over here with my partners, my friends, and start digging. So there they are, running them up. So looks like John's doing a clean out. Dana doing a sample clean out, seeing if he's on the gold, I'm sure. have to look at cleanouts later. Looks like Jesse's doing a sample. We'll get back to him in a minute. Let me see. Let's see.
There's two pieces there.
Yep. Let me see your baby gold.
Right there.
Let me see.
Baby gold.
Yeah. Now it's just gonna pull a shovel full out of here.
Oh, awesome. Yeah.
You know,
I pulled it.
I'm looking at this.
A lot of heavies in the little vortex cup in that green mat. Looking good. We have a couple of specs in the pan, so we're going on it. Later on, I'll see how John's doing and Dano. How'd you do on your clean out?
Really crappy, Ed. Really crappy.
That happens really sometimes. You're welcome.
I went up on that bank. I'm going to reposition, and I'm going to dig right where I was yesterday. We did good yesterday, so...
Well, might as well continue. Follow it. Chase it.
Yep.
Chase your lead.
So we're going to set up.
And that follows what we were talking about earlier today.
Right.
That this spot right here, during the flood, is probably a big vortex.
Right. Right, then it goes in the line that way, then probably out a little.
We got real tiny, a few little tiny spots over there. So I'm thinking the concentration is going to be right in here.
Well, we'll find out. You got how many specks in one shovel?
Three.
Okay.
About three of them in that shovel full right there.
Okay.
So I'm right for three in shovel full. All
right. Got gold. Dana's throwing rocks at me. Here's Dano and Patrick's, or I mean Patrick's and Caleb's hole. There's kind of a pathway right there that shovels our holes out to that pry bar. And how does it look like?
This is the stuff on the bottom of the bucket under the mat.
Right.
Somebody asked us about if there was any gold in that.
It might be Charles Moe's brother, because the last name's Moe, if I remember right in the comments.
So we're going to look and see. Because I just emptied that bucket, the bottom that was underneath everything, into here.
Right. Are you going up to your truck, Dana?
Yeah, I'm going to take my backpack. I'll be back down.
In my lunchbox? In my lunchbox, I think there's a pack of cigarettes. Could you bring them down?
Yep.
Any color in there?
Oh, yeah. There's color in there, too. Look at that.
Oh, yeah. I see three specks.
Four.
Right there.
There's one there, two right there, another one there.
See a lot of lead.
That piece.
Yeah, I see that one there. Wonder if I could zoom
oh, dude.
On it.
Wait. No. Damn. I was hoping. I was hoping to find a big chuck. But yeah, definitely check underneath the mat.
Yeah.
Definitely need to check under that mat.
Yep.
Got another piece? Look at that piece.
There's a nice one right there, Yeah, there is gold underneath the mat and in the bottom. I think he was talking about it when we were just using it without the rest of the other membrane.
Right.
Too.
So, but yeah, and I did check that too at one time. I did it and I checked, and yes, there is gold. We'll sit on the bottom there because the opening is up a little bit from the bottom. So definitely don't throw that dirt away without going through it.
Right.
That will go in with the rest.
Okay, well, I'm gonna start picking up.
That was full of gold, man. That was the keeper.
That had the nugget in it, doggone it. Oh, drop my gloves. Drop Jesse's gloves. Here, Jesse.
Just don't drop your sleuths, eh?
Again? I hear you. Doggone it. Well, we're packing up for day one. Huh? No, I want cold gloves in the morning or warmer gloves?
My chair! I gotta put my chair up.
There'll be cold gloves if we leave them out here. I'd rather put my hands in warm gloves than cold gloves.
Yes, sir.
Well, John. It was a
pleasure.
Pleasure meeting you, Mr. Miller.
You do this again?
Actually, my grandmother was a Miller. My mom's was a maiden name's Miller.
It's a popular
so
name.
So you never know. We could be related some way. I know I have family in the Midwest. And my buddy Dano the Mano. Toledo Jess in the background. I think we're going to head over and see Rich Cooley and
we're tired and hungry.
What's his friend? Rich Cooley and his friend.
We're going to feed our faces.
And
get some stuff in our bellies.
That's right.
In my belly.
The wandering buffaloes. And everybody else. Carrie and who else? Derek. I don't know if he's here or not. Well, we'll see. Till then.
Yes, are these yours?